Hello my dear students, welcome to our channel MST Physics, where physics gets charged. So here now we are going to discuss about the Ampere's law. This Ampere's law stating that here when any current carrying conductor carries the current, so that according to Oersted around it magnetic field is generates, and this Ampere's law giving the relation between the produced magnetic field and the current carrying conductor, and according to this Ampere is stated that the line integral of the magnetic field around any closed path, line integral B bar dot dl bar, surface integral B bar dot ds bar, here about this line is the curved path, so that I am taking B bar dot dl bar for a closed path, is equals to mu naught times the net current enclosed by this surface. Means if this path will be enclosed by how much amount of current here, I, so that we can write mu naught I is the Ampere's law. Once again, standardly it can define the line integral of magnetic field induction around any closed path is equals to mu naught times the net current enclosed by that path here. It is similar to the Gauss law in the electrostatics. So we already learned that Gauss law, whenever we are placing the charge at anywhere around this, it produces the electric field. Because of producing electric field, there should be electric flux enclosed by that surface around the charge, right? So according to Gauss, the total magnetic flux through any closed surface, so that B bar dot ds bar, is equals to 1 by epsilon times the net charge enclosed by that surface. Means if there is a charge at any point are enclosing by that surface, so that only the magnetic flux will be produced. Because of that, the total magnetic flux through any closed surface is equals to 1 by epsilon times the net charge. The net charge means depends on the number of charges, like you may take Q1, Q2, Q3 and so on, plus minus. So according to this, here you can write the B bar dot ds bar is equals to 1 by epsilon naught of Q1 minus Q2 plus Q3 is the meaning of a net charge enclosed by that surface. Similar to this, here also, if you are consider any closed path irrespective of the shape here, so inside this closed path we have the number of conductors, sum of into the plane of the paper and sum of out of the plane of the paper. Here the total line integral of magnetic field strength around this closed path is equal to net current enclosed by that surface. The net current should be within that surface only. The currents which are outside this closed surface does not affecting the total magnetic field strength for this given surface. Similar to that, here also, if I remember in the Gauss law, if you are supposing the one more charge Q4, it does not affecting the total flux enclosed by this surface. So here, and according to sign convention, into the plane of the paper is taken to be negative direction, negative z axis. Away from the plane of the paper, it is a positive z axis, so that for a given loop, the line integral of magnetic field strength for any closed surface or path, for closed path, is equals to mu naught times the net current. Now the net current can be written as I1 minus I2 plus I3. I am taking the convention as away from the plane of the paper of the current is taken to be positive, into the plane is taken to be negative here. And these I4 and I5 does not affecting the net magnetic field through this closed line. Here it is the Ampere's law in the magnetism. This is what Gauss law in the electrostatic. This is stating about the charge, and here it is stating about the current here. So now we will going to discuss how this Ampere's law is useful or helpful or using to find the magnetic field induction due to current carrying conductor. So now we are going to find the magnetic field induction due to a cylindrical current carrying wire. So here this cylindrical wire may be of a solid cylinder or hollow cylinder, right? So because of that cylindrical wire, when it carries the current around that magnetic field is generates, So that we are going to find the magnetic field induction due to this current carrying circular coil inside on the surface and outside. So as here this cylindrical wire is a solid, means like this is the entire wire is a solid completely made up of the material. If you are said to be this a hollower one like this, only the surface material is made up of the surface only, the inner one is the empty. Otherwise, to understand clearly, so when you are coming to here, this is the solid cylindrical wire. So this complete surface carrying the current, because of that we are going to find the magnetic field induction here or here or here. These distances as are varies from the center. Okay, and a hollow cylindrical wire means this. So here this is what carrying the current now, with center it has the inner radius and outer radius, if you are the thickness is the considerable, right? So about this we'll discuss in the next video. Now whatever we discuss is the magnetic field due to this cylindrical current carrying wire here. So here this is the center, this complete radius is R with the reddish one. So now I am considering one small Ampere's loop of radius R, where we are going to find the magnetic field induction. So for this I am considering one small element of this circular loop of length dl, and this Ampere's loop carrying the current I dash. So we are going to write here current through wire. Of course, it is a solid cylinder, is a I, right? Current per unit area are said to be current density. Is said to be what? Current density, current per unit area can be written as I by pi r square. The whole cylindrical wire having the radius r, so that surface area will become pi r square. This is said to be J. Now, I'm going to write current through the Ampere's loop of radius small r is supposed to be I dash. That I dash can be written as current per unit area into area of this Ampere's loop is a pi r square, which gives the current through that wire. So now we can write the magnetic field due to this part of the wire is the line integral B bar dot dl bar is equals to mu naught times the net current enclosed by this Ampere's loop is a I dash. Here we know B bar dot dl bar is the BDL cos theta, and dl is the tangent drawn here, and when you are taking the current carrying conductor here, so the magnetic field is the clockwise only, a tangential to it, means B and dl bar in same direction. So BDL cos 0, so we can write the line integral B into dl is equals to mu naught times the current is I by pi r square into pi r square. So here B integral dl is nothing but the length of this element, such kind of combining all the elements, we will get this circular loop. What is the length of this circular loop? Is nothing but its circumference, isn't it? Means 2 pi r is equals to mu naught I into r square by capital R square. Pi pi get cancelled here. So our intention is to find the B inside that cylindrical wire is equals to, we can write mu naught I into r by 2 pi r square is the expression for the magnetic field induction. R you can also write this in terms of current density. You can write the current in terms of current density as mu naught I into r, sorry, I by pi r square is a J, so by 2. This is the expression for B inside a current carrying circular loop is a mu naught J r by 2 in terms of current density, and here it is in terms of current only. So now the second case we may take that point, this is the first case is, here I will write R is less than capital R. Now the second case is R is equals to R means now the point is on the surface of the wire, on its surface. When it is on its surface, so that simply here you can write a B on the surface is equals to mu naught I, this R become capital R by 2 pi R square. So that we will get B on the surface is mu naught I by 2 pi R is the expression for B on the surface. So now I am consider the point here which is at the distance of small r. Now that small r is greater than capital R. And here to find the magnetic field induction here, we should consider the entire current carrying loop. So now for this case, the total current is I, and according to Ampere's law, the line integral B bar dot dl bar is equals to mu naught times the total current is I now. And here we are imagine one imaginary ampere loop. So for this loop, we are going to find the magnetic field. And so that its length will become what? B into 2 pi r. This 2 pi r is the length of this imaginary path. Okay, or ampere path is equals to mu naught I by r by this, by this. Here we can write B outside is equals to mu naught I by 2 pi small r. Means here the observable thing is B inside is mu naught I into R by 2 pi R square, which means B inside is directly proportional to R. When it is directly proportional to R, means from the center to we are moving away from the center towards the surface, the generating magnetic field is start to increases. When it start to increases, which means that is at a center B is a zero, and next on the surface it is a maximum. And whose expression is mu naught I by 2 pi R, right? Mu naught I by 2 pi R. And B on outside is mu naught I by 2 pi R, which means is inversely proportional to R, which means it is inversely proportional to R. Means as it moves away from the surface, again B value what happens is start to decreases. Okay, is inverse relation. So now by observing these points, these are the highlights of this application. So now we are going to plot the graph for this case. So here by observing these points, we got that B at a center is zero, and from center to the surface B start to increases, and linearly as it is directly proportional to R, so that we will get a straight line passing through the origin because of linear relation. And it will become maximum on the surface. So and whose value is mu naught I by 2 pi R. And outside the cylindrical wire, it is inversely proportional to R, which means we will get a rectangular hyperbola, and it tends to zero at a infinite distance. This is what the graphical representation of this variation of B due to solid cylindrical wire right from center to away from the wire here. And based on this, we'll taking one problem here, the important one. So they are asked to find the ratio of magnetic field at a R1 is equals to R by 2 to the, simply I am writing the question, R2 is equals to 2R of a cylindrical wire of radius R. So by this, as we are taking R1 is equals to R by 2, which means that point lies inside the cylindrical wire. What is the expression for B inside the cylindrical wire? Is a mu naught I into R by 2 pi R square. But here is a B1, means it is a R1. So mu naught I by 2 pi R square is a common. So this R is equals to, we can write R by 2. The capital R is given in the question. So that here we will get a mu naught I by 4 pi R is the expression for B inside it. How we know that it is inside R? When they are given the cylindrical wire, of radius r, then r by 2 will be lies inside it and 2r will be lies outside the cylindrical wire, right? So now I am going to find the b at the distance of 2r, so that here we can write b2 is equals, what is the expression for b outside here? Mu naught I by 2 pi r. Here it is b outside. So with the help of this expression we can write b2 as mu naught I by 2 pi, the r value is a 2r, so therefore mu naught I by 4 pi r, and the required question is to find the ratio of magnetic fields at the distance of r by 2 to 2r. So at the distance of r by 2 we have here mu naught I by 4 pi r upon, at the distance of 2r is mu naught I by 4 pi r, means both are having the same values, which means the ratio of b1 to b2 at the distance of r by 2 to 2r is 1. This is the way. Otherwise they may be also asking the numericals based on these equations. Means these are the highlight points and the direct points which are helpful in attempting the question directly or may solving the numericals. This is a very important one. Thank you students, thank you for watching. If you like my videos, do like, share, comment and subscribe my channel to get latest videos.